names. You have learned that names always had symbolic meaning among the people, and were the reflections of the people's individual medicines. Within seven arrows, you will meet many different people. Their names will tell you much about them. They will tell you of their medicines and of their ways of perceiving. One of these reflections you will meet will be Day Woman. Translated within the people's tongue, Day Woman means woman of the sun or truth. This name is also the sign of sun dancing, or the seeking of harmony. You will also meet a person called Hawk. The hawk is the little brother of the eagle. This person's medicine sign means that he was born with the gift of seeing both at a distance and closely. Of course, this should be interpreted symbolically rather than literally. Hawk's gift was the ability to perceive clearly and broadly the things of the mind, the heart, and of the way of the people, the Sundance way. Red Hawk was this man's color. Red symbolizes fire. Fire represents the living spirit of the people, and it also tells us that Hawk perceives with the illumination of the golden east. Within the story of Seven Arrows, Nightbear's name and his way of perceiving are also explained. As you learn of these things, you may also find your own name. The stories. There are many old stories told within Seven Arrows. These stories were used among the people to teach the meaning of the Sundance way. They were themselves a way of understanding among the people, and also between different peoples. Because the people did not have a written language, these stories were memorized and passed down in one way through countless generations. The stories are about both animals and people. You will find stories about mice, wolves, raccoons, otters, and buffalo. These stories are almost entirely allegorical in form, and everything in them should be read symbolically. Every story can be symbolically unfolded for you through your own medicines, reflections, and seekings. As you do this, you will learn to see through the eyes of your brothers and sisters, and to share their perceptions. Questioning is one of the most vital paths to understand these stories, which will teach you of the Sundance way. When you question, the medicine wheel is turned for you. These stories are magical teachers in this way. They are flowers of truth, whose petals can be unfolded by the seeker without end. These stories were meant to be told, not written. In this way, the teachers, whether speaking verbally or in sign language, were able to give inflections to particular words to reflect their symbolic content. For example, the word year holds many different meanings. It reflects the concept of a cycle, which is symbolically represented by a circle, which in turn symbolizes the medicine wheel and the universe. Similarly, the word way can mean simply a path or direction, but it can also mean an entire philosophy of life, a religion, or a way of perceiving. Within Seven Arrows, and particularly within the old stories, the words to which the teller would have given inflections are capitalized. These words are symbolic teachers, and it is very important that you approach them symbolically rather than literally. These capitalized words may sometimes seem inconsistent, but do not be confused by this. The coyote is known among the people as a gentle trickster, and his way is a part of Sundance learning. I want you, my brothers and sisters, to know that I too am still learning about the way of the people. The understanding of this way is not found just through the memorization of stories and symbols. It is a living, growing thing that comes from touching and experiencing within each of the four great directions. The Sundance Way itself is a living thing. It is always growing and turning within the people. It is not to be learned by studying archaic rituals or traditions, but by seeking, understanding, and then allowing it to grow within your own heart and mind. Within Seven Arrows, there are many ancient stories taught to me by my fathers and grandfathers. But there are also new stories that I have written from within my own understanding and experience. They are there as teachings from which you can learn, in which you can build upon in your own way. This turning and growing is called the building of the Thunderbow. Seven Arrows itself, from beginning to end, is a teaching story. It is a story of the Sundance Way, constructed in the same manner in which I was taught by my fathers to tell stories. It is a complete medicine wheel, all by itself. Read the book with a friend, wife, or loved one, or best of all, with children. You too are a medicine wheel, and the magic of your perceiving will be unfolded.